Hey, Street Flower! Oh my god. I'm still new to streaming, but yeah, I'll try. I want people to know this game because it's so good. Yeah, I have quite shit tonight. Yeah, it's expected to be in 480p, because if I stream at 720, it's not gonna be good, I guess, for you guys. Plus, it might not handle my video, it's gonna give me drop frames. Arcade Spirits, written by Stephen Kang and Aang Shu. I probably did not pronounce that right. Hello, my name is Iris, and I'm your personal digital assistant. I'll be getting you ready to experience one day in the life of an exciting world of arcade management. I promise you'll be excited. Really, trust me. 99.97% exciting minimum. Before we begin, can you please tell me about yourself? Oh. Your name, what you look like, that sort of thing. Name should be... I don't know, I'm not good with surnames. I guess. Pronoun. Oh yeah, it does sound like there's a party, yeah, but it's in a net cafe, so that's why it's quite nice. I'll get a PC set up soon, just so it will be quiet at home. Hairstyle. Scored short. Chloe Price kind of lesbian haircut? Alright, there we go. Hair color to violet to dark. There we go. Eye color. Bluish. Yes. So correct. Demo expected a distant future, year 2020. Okay. We can't know what year is it yet. Probably 2069. Wait. Yesterday I was unemployed. Today I'm taking me back in a working class. Unemployment is not good. I can't believe I let that weird girl app lives in my phone talking to us. I feel like Iris is gonna be really integral for the game. In the full game, please. For now, she's just like the introductory. I mean, I needed a job, but working in an arcade? here in 20 something, video arcades are pretty mainstream, like going out to the movies or grabbing pizza or something. I wish it would be mainstream just so I'd have an excuse to like go out. Because arcades are fun. Although back in 19, yeah, this is a real one. We narrowly avoided a video game crash, which might have destroyed the whole industry. Dodge a bullet there. Just imagine if it actually destroyed the whole video game industry. There might not be. Video games might be like an underground kind of thing. Maybe in the squatters area. And the ones and the only activities that people will do, probably go out to movies, making music. Yeah. There won't be any gaming related careers if that would have happened. Actually, working in an arcade is risky, like working in a landmine factory. Particularly, a little mom and pop place like this one could go bankrupt any day now. I'm sure you'll fit in just fine, dearie. Everybody here has a dream work shift. No doubt you'll find yours as well. I can't do like character voices, I'm so bad at that. It's what she told me when I joined on Francine's arcade fun place. I don't know if working here is my dream exactly. Truthfully, I haven't been to an arcade in, let's see, 15 years. Wow, fuck. Imagine not being able to go to an arcade for 15 years. I can't imagine that. I should be... It's every kid's dream come true, hell yeah. I'm willing to take this seriously. Might be too stiff. I'm looking for hope after so long. Too sentimental. Too fearsome. I can go with the flow. Okay, it's sort of my mantra. No matter how weird or dismal life gets, go with the flow. That's okay, dude. Yep. Neutrality. At least my first day has been pretty quiet. No customer service crisis for me to deal with. Just a bunch of regulars playing their usual games, and of course my coworkers. Good. Well, wander the floor a bit. My accent is not good. See if anybody needs help. There's... Oh! Now there's two Naomis! There's Naomi Fairchild, our techie. She fixes up these old 1980-something games, which are constantly breaking down. So that's what happens with old arcades. Hey, they're both just gonna call themselves Naomi. Ah. Oh, no. It's like she's talking to herself. Settling in, okay? No problem. Did you have lunch yet? Can you pass me that multimeter before the power supply in this game melts down? Sure, here you go. Thanks. Figured since it's quite near today, I'd do some work on the floor. Although I should probably go grab some replacement parts. Excuse me. Oh shit, this looks like that character from Dream Daddy. I don't know who. I've never played. Next up is Percy Sinclair, our world record high score chaser, and Mr. Loopy's Magic Mouse. Hottest arcade title of 1980-something. It's kind of like a mix of Dig Dug and Pac-Man, to be honest. He's been working on hitting that goal ever since coming over here from England, as far as I know. possibly without food or sleep. Hey, person, did anything? Snack? Some water? Making rounds?
Oh, no, no, I'm quite well, thank you.
How long have you been standing there? Don't you need to go to the bathroom eventually? That's what extra lives are for. I appreciate the concern, love, but I'll be just fine. Thanks for the inquiry, mind you. Next, I swing by our Fist of Discomfort machine, which always has some fierce competition going down between esports pros and wannabes. Yeah. Oh. I messed up the settings. Alright, now I'm back. Making sure. There we go, I'm back. Let me just. There we go. Esports pros and wannabes. In case it wasn't clear, the one on the left is a pro, Queen B, representing L7 Gamer. What does L7 mean? A prestigious COD team. She even uses a portable rig of webcams and lights to stream her matches over the internet. Funflex is basically a personal broadcaster. I'm looking at the screen, I'm thinking what the gameplay might be for this game. Kinda looks like if Slay the Spire were like, if Slay the Spire and King of Fighters were combined. You need anything, Quinby, during rounds? No, oh, come the fuck. I know what it is. There's no effing way that's even possible. Those hitboxes don't even effing connect. Who cares? This isn't a tournament. I'm taking the win. Yeah, sorry, not happening. Did I mention I happened to buy an extra ultimate technique scroll from the item store? I can't do the take this. I can't exclaim for some reason. What? How did you defeat me? Oh. Hell yeah. True gamer. Wow, Queen Bee's really going at him today. That's Ashley. She works the floor alongside me, solving any arcadey type problems we find out. So basically, supervisor. I wonder if her annihilating every single person who walks up to the game is really helping the arcade in the long run. You tell me. I'm new here. I don't know anything about anything. Yeah. At the very least, it's entertaining to watch. Hey, thanks for covering the floor. I need to head back and work on my pinky costume. Head keeps falling off. Cosplay's work is never finished. Ashley walked away. Lastly, we have... Oh, dance, DDR? Spotlight stage... Okay. Dance team leader, Taya. Having a lovely day, not half as lovely as you wish that. Okay, chill it. Just around, like Gavin told me to do, nothing special going on. If you ever want to show me your moves, you know where to find me. Alright, how could I forget about Gavin? Do you pronounce it Gavin or Gavin? He's the business manager. Well, he doesn't own the place. But close enough. Oh yeah, I forgot it's a day, so it just shows MX. It's not Mr. or Miss. I see. I trust your first day's going well. No issues. All's quiet on the Western Front. What? Western Front. Okay. Good, good. Only a few more hours till closing. With any luck, we can escape today in a reasonably profitable state and live to see another day. I got... Jesus Christ. Why is the ice there? Why is the ice there? What? Semi-terrifying us. You tell me. Pinky the Funflex Community. I nearly went into cardiac arrest the first time. So, I mean, if I saw something like that in real life, I'd generally run, I guess. Not at the second time.
Oh.
Why is the ice there? That's the only question I have. Next time we've got a bunch of peeps here, I'll be ready. I'm happy to announce our Joust is fixed. Joust. Wait, there's an arcade for Joust? That's like a really, really, really old game. I remember you had to like... So it's like a platformer, but like on one stage that just slowly melts down. Not a bad first day for you, Naomi. First day at Francine's Arcade Fun Box. Hope you had fun. Yeah, sure. Game of it. Thank you for playing. By the way, I booked a birthday party for this afternoon. Wait, you can book a birthday party at arcades? I've never seen that. Oh no. Oh no. What's gonna happen? Sorry, I meant to tell you dears, but I can't forget. Birthday party. How old are the kids, I guess? It's a fifth birthday. Oh, to be young again. But oh no. Them handling kids. Throwing ski balls overhand into the glass. Jumping out from down with pinball machines. Putting chewing gum into coin slots. Pulling up my costumes. Now, Ashley, keep it together. We've survived kids' birthday parties before. Yeah? Doom, the end is nine. The world is gonna burn, Naomi. Well, I'd hate to get in the way of all the fun. Time for my afternoon nap, anyway. Have fun, dears. Battle stations. Okay. I'll take ticket desk so I can oversee operations. Ashley, greet the kids. Naomi, watch for hardware. Which Naomi? Roaming tree. Oh, that Naomi, and then my Naomi. They are coming. Rumble is felt before the scene. Parents pulling into the parking lot, minivans disgorging. I haven't seen that word in a while. And suddenly, an explosion of small humans. Small humans. Rushes the doors, bursting into the arcade before scattering every which way. Even before any of them can get tokens, they're grabbing at joysticks, mashing buttons, eager to get the game on or even just pretend to be playing. The crew assumes battle stations. Naomi by the fragile pinball machines. Ashley near the door, trying to distract the incoming kids to greet them. They'd probably scare them. Gavin. Armed with pre-stacked $10 rolls of tokens, quickly exchanges them with the adults, beats waiting in line for change machines. Yeah. As for the pro gamers, well, Queen Bee and Teo's friends bolt for the exit, abandoning them. Keen on getting out ahead of the search of kitties, I guess. Yeah, it's just gonna be a huge distraction. If you're a pro gamer and then there's like massive amounts of kids, then that's all very well and good. I've got no idea where I'm supposed to be. Roaming duty, Gavin said, looking for trouble. Look for trouble. I mean, I was doing that before, but now the case is multiplied. For a few minutes, I'm like a pinball being bounced around, or like that frog trying to cross a highway of traffic. You mean frog? Eventually, I spot three possible problems on the rise, and Naomi, PFA, is ready to attend to them. Which one of these do I want to tackle first? Near Naomi, Ashley, near Teo, and Queen. Shouting adults and crying children are never particularly good signs. And I hope beyond hope that I can take this one. I shake the discomfort. Now's not the time to doubt myself. I need to find out what's going on and stat. Stat, pronto. So I get closer to the revving of engines and the clacking of shifting gears. I see a grown woman berate a cowering boy. Admit it, I know what you did, you brat. You manipulated my precious son to put his token to your game. You should be ashamed of yourself. I come to your crying voice. Children like you are the absolute worst. Garbage! Man, keep your voice down. There's no need to shout and chat or less. What's going on here?
This jerk of a boy told my sweetest fiance Josh that he should put his own tokens into the racing machine so he could play it for free.
The mom probably has web feet.
Josh earned his tokens from his own allowance, and now won't let some devil child steal his money.
Let's just take a moment to calm down, okay? Before I say anything else, I spot Queen Bee and Tayo out of the corner of my eye. Queen Bee looks infuriated and Tayo has buried his face in his hand. Actually, now that I stop and think about it, they might have seen some info. Racing games are right next to Showtime stage. Tayo probably had a good vantage by the whole thing if he was dancing on stage. Just by the way, Queen Bee's brows are furrowed, I can tell something's not steering right here. Try to solve this one by myself. That's not a good decision. Solving it yourself.
Ask the pro gamer.
I wave her over to Trent. I attempt to reach out to her for guidance. Ma'am, I know you're upset right now, but I think that late. Jesus. I just noticed what Queen Bee's wearing. It's actually like really, really stylistic. Nope, not her. This is in fact the furthest way from helping I could ever envision. Kid runs away to avoid the loud people as I try my best to defuse this situation. That boy did nothing wrong. Nothing.
Excuse me?
Hot.
How dare you?
There's no way I'm getting a word in between these two. I sigh and resign myself to watching it play out. Hello there, I can't yell! I don't care what if he did watch a claim or not. You've got no right to traumatize him over it.
He's a thief and he'll grow up to be a no-good criminal.
That still doesn't fucking matter. Do you honestly think, right? Take a single fucking second in your life and really think. Shouting at a child is an effective way to handle this.
You can't tell me how I should act.
That's not a real answer. Why not try asking the boy what happened before you jump down his throat? Shut up and listen before you assume you knew everything. That's not.
Who do you think you are?
She does her intro. I'm the nemesis of evil doers. Say that with a straight face. Writer of wrongs. Rising star of... Oh, Lucky 7. Queen Bee poses in her trademark pose. What would be her trademark pose? I'm the one and only Queen Bee. Again, imagine saying that with a straight face. And in the name of the fun fact, I'll punish you. Did she, like, slap her or something? In all my years.
You're far worse than that impudent child. Josh, get over me. You're leaving this horrible arcade right now.
Well, that's one way to handle that. The woman's... scoops up her child and storms out the front door. I don't think we'll see her or her son anymore, and frankly, I'm okay with it. Once they are gone, Queen Bee turns her attention back to me. Ugh, people like that really piss me off? Yeah. Why is it censored? My blood's still boiling. Oh, hey, thanks for the backup. You're welcome. I ain't really doing much of anything. Yeah, well, I knew you had my back, kid. I can sense if you're like me. I can't stand to see people get screamed. I don't know what accent I should use for Queen Bee. Do I use, like, a fake British one? I can't sense if you're like me. I can't stand to see people get screamed at. I can't do it. It sucks. Oh, no. What? Who hurt Queen Bee? Who hurt? Bay. Bay. There's a side of her I haven't seen. She just looks so sad. No. No. Nope, this is not good. I'm not going to cry. Nah, might as well be concerned. No, it's really none of my business. I feel I shouldn't ask about this. Looks like the incident didn't happen. It's okay, you can tell me. For her moment. Look at her, she's so sad. Who hurt Queen Bee? I'll be fine. Hey, thanks for asking. I appreciate it. How old is Queen Bee anyway? Show's over. Should go check on that boy. Oh yeah, I forgot the boy about this. I always am. If you excuse me, and I need to try to squeeze in a few more matches before Queen Bee. Queen Bee takes one more moment to triangulate the safest path back to face the discomfort to receive children. After poking around a bit, I managed to find a kid, so he was shaken up from the whole ordeal. Hey, sorry about all that. Are you going to be okay? I think so. I swear I did not hit her. The other kid, he just came out of nowhere and dropped his token in my flat. After I lost, I got up the game and offered it to him. He just ran away. Well, that other kid was the dickhead then. And then that woman approached me and started yelling. Boy nuts, swiping his snotty nose in his sleeve. Well, if it's any consolation, the bad lady's gone. I don't think she's going to ever come back. Did she roast her? Boy, she has still streaked into it. Let's smile spreading. Thank you, and tell the other lady, thanks for sticking up to me too. Alright, that sorted out. Only got time to deal with one more problem. Stolen tickets or cupcakes? What's more concerning, cupcakes or tickets? I love how there's like a dilemma. You can smell disaster in the room and smell sweet. Sweet disaster. I think I can smell the box of birthday cupcakes one of the parents left near the ticket desk. With kids swarming around it, scavenging for their favorite icing cone. Icing. Someone thought of those icing blob cupcake cakes. Superior to actual birthday cake. Nah. You listen, my OC. The cupcakes are way better than actual cakes, okay? Especially on the icing part. Because ices are disgusting. There are clearly larger issues at stake than that. Ellen Chaplin, don't take all the chaplain. I want two cupcakes. We need two cupcakes. Okay. No fair. Everybody gets one and mine's gonna be chocolate. Finders keepers. Who uses that phrase nowadays? Parents aren't paying attention. They're too busy complaining about being depressed, okay. Meaning when the first cupcake is thrown, nobody's there to stop it. Oh no. I want chocolate. Blobby wads of icing and sponge cake go flying. I glance over to the coin-operated games, which are about to get caught in the crossfire. Now me, who's busy trying to unjam his joystick when the kids waggle too hard. Looks up to see the cupcake onslaught coming her way. As does Ashley, whose fuzzy costume is a nice and inviting target for flying confection. Eggfest. Why is there an option to save them both? Of course I'll take this. I like how it looks quite ominous, as like it's an airsoft pellet. Numbness sets in as multiple rounds of frosting coated mortar. See? Fire impact against my back. I finally hit the ground, my clothes are totally ruined. But alas, my noble self-sacrifice cannot completely protect him. Nami seems to get dead, and she's gamed thereby. A few cupcakes that miss me, otherwise no damage done. Ashley takes a few shots, unfortunately, but it could have been worse. As parents swarm to round up the cupcake war instigators, Nami and Ashley kneel down to check in my fallen corpse. You're talking to yourself. Could be paralyzed from the neck down. Nami, blink once if you're paralyzed. Blink twice if not. I'm not, but... hell, she isn't. How can you be paralyzed in that one? Oh, hey, or you could talk, that works too. Yeah, okay. Although I have to be careful not to mingle my icing with her icing in the process. Days like this, I'm glad I wear an apron. Ew, cupcakes are food, not fashion. Colored icing is just the worst. I think I can get this out with some club soda, unfortunately. Guess they got all of us, huh? But now... No, that was super selfless of you, trying to save us from the splatter. Speaking as a floor attendant, you score a silver medal. While covered in tons of cupcakes. This suggesting I should have been fat. It's kind of like the cringy part of Queen Bee. This seems more normal. Can always hit the laundromat, no problem. What about you two? Nami in your apron. Ashley, want me to get you a club soda? Need to check my tools. Make sure none of them got red, but I'm good otherwise. Thanks for the upgrade. I'll attend to my customers. Devil's in the details. Thanks, Nami. That was a complete mess, but I guess it could have been more of a complete mess if you hadn't done that. I'd better get back trying to fix. I'd better get back to fixing this joystick. You should clean up and get back to it. Also, the party's still going. Good luck. Yeah, good luck. Hey, good work. If you'll excuse me, I need to go clean up a little pinky bit. I need water for this. I'll be back. Alright, I'm back. I decided to eat like small lunch, I guess.
Yeah, good luck. And hey, good work. If you'll excuse me, I'll need to go clean up poor Pinky a bit. He does.
Cardiac arrest, Flamingo. Oh, that could have gone better.
It could also have gone much, much worse.
More importantly, I kept her spirits up.
Even Ashley, who has to clean icing out of her fuzzy felt,
came out of it cheerfully.
With a brief nod from Gavin, I snatched one of the official Funflex t-shirts to replace my cupcake cup. After a few minutes in the bathroom to change and wipe icing off my pants, I'm ready to go again. Two problems and a can. Now to deal with that crying kid by the skee-ball machines. Oh, she's done. Okay. Percy looks up briefly from clearing level 78?
I don't know what level is, like the 13th key on Pac-Man, the NES Pac-Man, or the arcade version.
I couldn't beat until that point. Looking for that girl? I think her parents took her out. Party turned sour for her, I suppose. You can't be everywhere at once, Naomi. Cheer up, love. You're still doing better than the last guy stood up your post. Seconded. I saw your deal with that obnoxious friend, and with a cupcake run. You did well today. Why would it be weird for your boss to be smiling at you? Things seem to be cooling down. I suggest you take a few minutes in the break room while there's a lull in the action. Ashley and I will handle things for now. She can swap off when you come back. I could use a few minutes, yeah. Thanks, Gavin. I'll be right back. I slip away, headed for the employee lounge. Some hours later, from the cars pulling up in the parking lot, it looks like the party's over. If in real life that would be good. No more kids. It's just about closing time for the arcade anyway. Most of the gamers have filed out by now if they hadn't already fled the tidal wave of kitties. My first impulse is to go bug Gavin to finish up my employment paperwork at Gavin. Gavin sad. Ashley sad. Naomi sad. Couldn't be done with their stream. Teo, okay. Guinness World Record guy. Let's go back to our bay. Queen Bee looks like she's completely done for the day. There's an exasperated frown on her face as she shoves various webcams and mics. Does she seriously do that? Imagine if this was in real life. I didn't know you're allowed to do that on arcades. She doesn't even notice me as I approach. I mean, I guess it is allowed, because, you know, even Tekken World Tour, I guess, they do that sometimes. Fuck yeah, anarchy. Careful, you don't want to break anything. She's angry. I'm not gonna... What are you doing, okay? Just get frustrated and I'm not playing at my best. This is an appropriate response. Let's assault flow with. Ha, not exactly. I shouldn't be taking my anger out of the queue, but I was just effing hate losing. And no Johns, but it's so hard to concentrate with a mass of children running around. Not that they aren't entitled to all the cell phone. The Funflex is for everyone. Sticky hands, touchy. Just imagine this horror dialogue. when those sticky hands touch you and you aren't expecting it. I was right. Also, the yelling probably doesn't help either. Right? Why are they always yelling? They're kids. But you lose some, you win some, you lose some. Right, kid? Yeah, that's how I feel after today's shift. It was rough out there. Normally, I'd leave the gathering that calibers around. But I've got an important tournament coming up, and I need all the practice I can get. Kids are not. For your first day, you held your own. I'm impressed. Really? I've dealt with my fair share of brats and trolls roaming around here, and you certainly held yourself up to be a higher standard than the last guy that worked here. I keep wondering who's this last guy that worked here. That's good, right? That's heckin' good, kid. I think you'll fit in nicely among this crowd of misfits. That's a relief. I was worried people weren't going to accept. If anyone gives you any trouble at all, you tell Queen Bee. I'll fight. Really, that's not necessary. I don't need people fisticuffing in my name. Gavin will most definitely fire me for that. Although thinking it over, I could see myself fighting for Queen Bee. Hell yeah. Be her devout servant. I now may swear that I'll be faithful servant to Her Majesty Queen Bee and bear loyalty with all to all her lands. Fist of discomfort cabinets across the land. Any place that has a FOD arcade is just her territory, her kingdom. Okay, you are too much. You have tenacity, no other shame. I accept. I, Queen Bee of the Funflex, Knight Naomi, go forth and protect my territory from trolls and haters alike. No, seriously, I'm going to mod you in my chat. Discord Queen Bee? Oh no, I can get way too used to this. Enough silliness. I have to get home and edit today's stream highlight reel. That's quite a workload after streaming for hours and hours. Queen Bee winks to me as she slings her bag over her shoulder, waves bye to all the lingers, and swiftly exits the complex. Okay, first day. Haunted arcades, crowded game conventions, cosplay craziness, and cutthroat. Not that intense. Not to mention the one rival who's waiting in the wings. Okay. Is this arcade seriously my dream job? Okay. Good days, bad days, I'm willing to ride them all out. I'm willing to see what my future holds. Do you want to do the same? A demo. The demo of Arcade Spirits. The winner is you. Hell yes. A basic bitch. You're also a basic bitch. Not bad. Finally, you've scored 1900 points. If you let's play this game, let us know. We'd love to watch your video. I don't know if I'd put it on YouTube. I guess I would. Thanks for playing Arcade Spirits. I hope to see you again in the full game. Design your own player character. Well, you can do that, but maybe more modifications, I guess, on the full game. Build relationships with 7 romanceable characters. Oh yeah, they leaked more characters. So, I remember Lily Pichu is gonna voice one of the characters that's not in the demo yet, but it's in the full game. I'm so excited because Lily Pichu, I watch her stuff. Grow your personality through role-playing choices. Your decisions affect the future of your arcade. Coming in 2019 from Windows, Mac, and Linux. ArcadeSpirits.com. Yeah. You guys should follow ArcadeSpiritsVN on Twitter.
one really good thing about this is that it really encapsulates the arcadey feel. It's like when back in 1970s, when arcades were like a huge hit, and there was just people would even save up like a jar of like just pennies, save a jar of pennies for fucking games. 1972 World Championship, World Arcade Championship or something. I know it was in pixels, but I think it was a footnote of history. So yeah, it's a good thing that this game, this visual novel encapsulates the arcadey kind of feel, like really well, really, really well. So yeah, you should go follow them. Wait, let me put a text in there. Arcades. Font size. No, no. Oh, I haven't had fonts yet. There we go. Background is black. Okay. There we go. So yeah, go follow them on. Go follow them on Twitter. I'll probably end the stream just because I only plan to dedicate the stream for this game, and maybe on Saturday I'll stream maybe League again, or maybe I'll do a podcast. I don't know. So I'm planning to get a co-host and, you know, search for more some topics to talk about for the podcast. So, yeah. Stay tuned for that. So, yep, go follow Arcade Spirits VN on Twitter. And this is late. I don't know how to do an outro. Late night. LNL for short. LNL, and I'll see you guys in the next stream. Bye. Peace.